This is Jilliana Ranicar-Breese, and I'm at Heiko Manor in Porvoo in Finland. And having been invited by the delectable Russian Galina Gorevaja, who I happened to meet in Crete. Did I pronounce your name correctly?
It's correctly.
Okay, more or less. And Galina is a fashion designer, amongst other things, and she lives in Porvoo, and she has a very unusual story because, in fact, she escaped from Russia. She took asylum in Finland. What year was that? How many years ago?
It's more than 20 years ago. It's 1992, 1993.
Okay, so tell me the background of what happened. You were unhappy in Russia and you wanted to leave, you wanted to escape.
Now, I was unhappy in politics, what was
the
in
political situation,
what was in Soviet Union.
Yes, what was it, or still communism, or had the wall come
it
down?
It was communism. It was perestroika already.
It's right, the wall hadn't come down.
It was always from the childhood.
Since your childhood, yes.
From my childhood, I was...
You always dreamt of going to America.
About, yes, United States.
Yes.
And my grandfather, from Second War, he was live in England.
15, he lived in England?
Yes, 15 years.
Oh.
And he has, I think that he has also family. Family, like family in Russian. He has wife and three daughters.
Yes.
One of them was my mother.
Yes.
And when he lived in England, he has wife there.
Oh, he had two wives?
Yeah, two wives.
Two families, but, two wives.
Yes, but nobody knows of us if our grandmother has some children in England.
Oh, you never found out?
We
you
know,
never did a
because
family?
Because he can't tell. In Soviet Union, it was very dangerous to tell how you live in border to another country.
Has he died now?
And
your
grandfather? He died.
In Russia?
Yes, in Siberia.
Oh, in Siberia. Oh.
When he came from England to Moscow, and from Moscow to Siberia, he was decided he come back in England, but it was impossible.
Okay.
Good that he survived in Soviet Union. He came 1960, about like this. I was not born.
You were born in Siberia.
Yes, I was born in Siberia. But when grandfather back to Russian, I was not born yet.
Yes. Okay.
My old sister, she was born already. So maybe I, when I grew up, I saw my grandfather, and he was unhappy.
Yeah.
He lived very, very poor. And I remember, I don't know from where, we have nothing about information about another country in Soviet Union.
That's right.
But I grow up in small village, and I always say that I moved to United States. I moved.
But
to
you
United.
Didn't know anything about the United States.
Nothing.
So it was
nothing.
A dream.
Yes, it was like a dream.
But you were always interested in fashion, weren't you?
Yes.
Because you are a fashion creator.
Yes, I was. When I was small,
yes,
it was easy for me to wear somebody, some another, my friend, for example. I design how to make from old clothes.
To recycle,
yes.
Yes.
And I remember we designed from, for example, from uniform.
Yeah.
Some uniform.
Yes.
Some beautiful things. Everybody asks, oh, from where you buy?
Uh-huh.
But in Soviet Union, it was difficult to buy good clothes somewhere.
Yes.
It was only the same clothes, gray.
Gray, yeah.
Not
color. Communist gray.
Yes. And when I was 24, 25, at first time I moved from St. Petersburg to Finland.
Yes,
only
but you didn't just move there, you escaped there.
I just come in to like tourist.
Yes.
For 2 days.
Yes.
It was like cruise.
Yes, you came by boat.
By boat, yes.
Yes, with friends.
With my friend, yes.
Yes, yes.
And but my friend was English teacher, English translator.
Yes.
And he knows about my plan, about my dream.
All right.
And I remember that...
But was this the first time that you'd left Russia?
No, it was second time. First time was when I was 21.
Yes.
I was lucky that I bought some tour. Have I said tour to Czechoslovakia and Hungary?
Okay, which was still under communist rule.
Yes,
of course.
It was. Yes, yes, yeah. So east country was Finland. It's first for me.
Finland was?
It was the first country
Which Europe. Was non-communist.
Yes, non-communist, yes.
Right, right.
And we came to here, it was summer, it was beautiful weather, by boat. I bought some souvenirs for my friends in Helsinki.
Presents,
yes. And I remember I had about 100 marks. It was not euro, it was mark.
German marks?
No, German, Finnish mark.
Oh, Finnish marks?
Finnish marks,
oh, right.
Yes.
How much would that be in euros today?
It's maybe enough for hotel, maybe one night.
Okay.
Or you can buy some blues.
Yes.
Yes.
So this was before Finland had the euro.
Yes, it was before.
Yeah,
before.
Yeah.
And we was tonight, we sleep in our boat, and we came from St. Petersburg to Tallinn by train, and from Tallinn to Helsinki by boat. So, it's coming day, we should back, and I was in the boat already, and I wait for my friend. It was many people coming on the boat because we live.
Yeah.
And then my friend say, Galina, what are you doing here? I said, the same what you are doing here. Go to home. And he say, Galina, now you have chance to move in United States. I say, how I can? Do you know what happened in our country? No. It was some, I don't know how to say in English. It's not...
We'll say it in Russian.
You know, it was in political, coming another minister and another is, it's fighting.
Yeah,
and
turmoil.
Yes, now you have a good position.
Yeah.
Because you can say that I don't want to go back because politics change it.
Yeah.
I never interested about
politics.
So
you were influenced
never.
By your friend?
Yes. I never interested about politics.
But your friend wasn't interested in going to America?
He was interested in go back or go from Russia, but he has family.
I see. And you didn't have family?
No. He has a wife and children.
Okay.
I was just alone.
Okay.
My mom, of course,
was his sister, but it's another thing. Yeah. So what did you do?
Actually,
you're going to tell me what you did in part two. Thank you very much, Galina.
Okay, thank you.